So here we have our Physocarpus capitatus, commonly known as Pacific ninebark in the Rosaceae family. So this species ranges from British Columbia and Alaska south into central California and then east to Montana and down into Nevada. It generally prefers moist, well-drained sites. It especially likes wetland environments, but can actually tolerate drought, which also makes it pretty popular as an ornamental species in some gardens. In terms of key identifying characteristics, this typically grows up to about 12 feet tall. The leaves, if we look closely, are alternate, so they're alternating on the stem. They are simple, and they are palmately lobed, much like a maple leaf. A key difference between the Physocarpus capitatus palmately lobed versus your Acer is the leaves are those lobes are a little bit more rounded than you would sometimes see on your Acers or your maples. And generally you will have anywhere from 3 to 5 lobes. Each of those lobes is also coarsely toothed. And then the fruit and the flowers are another really key characteristic. So the flowers are typically small white flowers that are borne in these hemispherical clusters. And then the seeds, or the fruits, are these really interesting follicles that will turn brown and dry out and will often persist over winter. So even when this tree loses its leaves, you can often identify it by that cap-like or hemispherical cluster of the Physocarpus capitatus. The bark on your Physocarpus capitatus, and even on the twigs, is typically thin, orange-brown, and exfoliates. So especially in winter, if you're trying to identify this without those palmate leaves, look for the exfoliating bark, which is especially noticeable if you look on the main stem. So that peeling, exfoliating bark is a really important characteristic, and those flat-top clusters.